Okay, good morning and good evening and welcome back in today's session, today's class of ServiceNow. Okay, today we are be on the second day of our ServiceNow class. Today topic is basically we are discussing that what is ServiceNow, what type of ServiceNow provides, what is the meaning of ServiceNow upgrade or update, and what type of users are available in ServiceNow. Okay. But before that, we start that discussion. Let me have a question to all of you. How you guys are managing your finance? It doesn't mean that you need to be telling me that Atul, where I need investment or I done investment. No. How you manage your finance? It means, do you guys write your financial things or your expenses or your income, maybe somewhere on a paper, on a laptop, on a phone, on an app? What do you think? Tell me, what do you think? Where you manage your finances, all finances? In Excel sheet, in mobile app? Say yes or no, maybe. Everybody is silent, that's bad. Okay, Equi, tell me. So, where you are managing your finance?
At the moment, I just look at my bank account and I use a piece of paper to write down things.
Okay.
But okay. I used to have access to Quicken financial planning and all that. But then when I left that job, I no longer have access to Quicken. And then ever since then, it's just been a piece of paper.
Okay, fine. It means that piece of paper is the place or is the way that you can see that how much money you have in your bucket as of now, right? Or maybe you can see, okay, how much expenses I done till now. Farha, what about you? Where you manage your finance? In paper, in mobile app?
It's a little similar to Atul.
Okay. Let me put one more question here then, and I'll go to Shahim for this. Shahim, I'm sure that you go for shopping or the grocery shopping kind of stuff with your parents. Okay, so where you write down all the grocery list that you need these many spices, these many other stuff for the kitchen? Where you manage all these things? A paper, or you're using some mobile app, or you're using your laptop, or you are using your mind to capture everything? Yes, Shyam, tell me.
Can do the lot of options. We can use a lot of options. We can capture something in mind. We can use our some people to note something.
Okay.
There is a lot of options that we can use.
Okay, now I put one more question on the top of that. Okay. Approximately 15-20 years back, it was rare that every house has a landline phone, right? The phone which we have a device in our home, you go and you call and then you connect with your relatives or your friends, right? During that time, where we guys are managing our contact numbers? Your mom, your dad write the contact number of the relative on a diary, right? With the name, Mr. X mobile number, phone number is this, Mr. Y phone number is this, right? I'm sure that we guys or my parents are maintaining the diaries or the papers where they write down every relative phone number in the same. But as soon as the mobile phones start coming into the picture, where I'm storing my contacts?
In the Gmail.
In the Gmail, okay. Okay, but Gmail came little later because earlier mobile phone just have a SIM card.
And
exactly, phone book. So when you say the phone book, it means we are talking about the phone book which is available in my mobile phone, right? The contact list or the phone book, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, yes.
So if this is the case, then my question comes, Atul, you take a lot of examples, but how these are related to the service now? So now think from the consultant perspective. Now think from the business analyst perspective. Now think from the pre-sales consultant perspective. If I say I used paper to write down my grocery, I use phone book to store my contact numbers, I use a mobile app to store my finances. In short, if I collect all these three or four mode of way of capturing the stuff, I can say these are all my tools which help me to serve some purpose for my need, right? I have a need to store the contact number. Mobile phone say, okay, why you worry? Use me. In mobile phone, you will get a phone book. Go and add, remove, update, or delete any contact number. So these are called the tools. So one thing I would like to clear here that ServiceNow is nothing but just a tool. Tool for the different purpose. Let's take an example, microwave oven. It is kind of a tool for me. It fulfills the purpose to grill anything. It can be non-veg or veg. It can help you to heat up anything, like you can make a rice or something. You can boil the water as well in the ovens. It can help you to bake the cake as well. Now, it can be cake, it can be cookies, it can be bread, it can be tea cake, it can be any type of cake you want to bake it. But in short, if I say that oven is just a tool for me to fulfill my requirement. Okay, so in the same way, as we are in the market at point of time, we are in the IT industry, and in IT industry, we have a lot of things in our plate. Lot of things are going in the market, lot of things going in the different places, and to manage each and everything, or up to some extent, we need some tool on the place. And that tool we are be discussing now is called the ServiceNow for me. Okay. Now, if you take example, if you have a Gmail account, you can access everything from the Gmail. One single account, you can access Gmail, you can access the Google Drive, you can access your photos, you can access your contacts, you can access your SMS as well. You can create your new accounts on the Facebook, on the LinkedIn, or the Orkut, or the Instagram by only one single Gmail ID. You can do multiple things. But in short, what is Gmail for me? It is just a tool which are giving a service to me to fulfill my requirements. Agree on this point? Any doubt, any question till now? I'm expecting some yes and no. Definitely.
Yes, yes.
Yes, okay. I agree.
Okay. So now first of all, Johnson says yes. He's agree with me. Okay. Now I would like to know from you, Johnson, that you have a mobile phone, definitely a smart mobile phone, right?
Yes.
What you can do with your mobile phone? Give me the minute options as well. What you can do with your mobile phone? Tell me.
I mean, you can use your mobile phone to place calls. Those are the. Oh, hold on. Sorry. You can use it to place calls. You can use it to check your emails. You can use it to check your investment if you trade stocks. You can use it to. Basically, your mobile phone now is like part of you now.
But what else you can do with the mobile phone? Calls, that's fine. Email, you can, that's fine. SMS is one other thing. You can run your Instagram, WhatsApp. Multiple mm-hmm. apps you can install on the mobile phone. Okay.
Yes.
Now let me put one more thing on the top of that. And Sachin, I need an answer from your side. Okay. Let's segregate these four or five facilities given by mobile phone in a different sections. Making call, putting SMS, taking the videos, taking the pictures, install the new apps on the top of that, use the Facebook and use the Gmail. Can you segregate these five or six options in a different sections? Like if I say making a mobile call and SMS, this is the basic functionality of a mobile phone. If any mobile phone cannot do this thing, you will not buy that mobile phone. Right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. Now let's segregate the other part. So one, I say it's a basic one. Then second option I'm giving to you.
Another one is the application platform, like social media platform is can segregate.
Okay, second option. Now go to the third category.
Yeah, third category, we can take like utilities.
Here
we can, even we can do micro segmentation as well, but yeah, for timing, macro level segment is fine.
Right. So now if we understand that by taking the example of a mobile phone, we are segregating mobile phone functionality in the three major categories. It can be, according to me, these are the three one, but according to Johnson, these can be different as well. Number one, we say the basic one, which includes making call and making or receiving SMS, number one. Second, it is a utility. You can install the new apps on the top of that. Number third, you can say advanced feature. You can do the folder segregation. You can do the printing from the mobile phone. You can do the checking of the emails from the mobile phone, right? Now, in the same manner, ServiceNow categorize himself in the multiple stuff, multiple categories. But when I say category, it means that I'm talking about the ServiceNow product only. Like, so if I show you, okay, before that, I'll tell this thing. So currently ServiceNow having a lot of modules, lot of new products available in the market, which can be used for the different purposes. Like I give mobile phone to my kid, he's 8 years old, but I lock everything in that mobile phone other than making call and receiving SMS. That's all. He don't need anything else. That is my requirement. I give a mobile phone to my wife, and I order with mobile phone, I order the earbuds as well, because she like to listen to music when she's working in kitchen, right? It means I'm putting some more flavor, putting some more products on the top of that, so that she will be able to use this product at the topmost level. Okay, we will discuss these things in the ServiceNow capability, definitely in today's class only. Okay, but before that, it is good to understand how ServiceNow cycle has been done, or how ServiceNow evaluated from version to version, version to version, version to version. I'm sure that we all are from, except maybe Roshan cannot be that from that particular category, but we all are from that age where we use Windows 95, Windows 98, MS-DOS we use, command prompt we use to do our work. I'm sure that we all are from that category only. Then version 2000 come, XP come, 2013 come, Vista come, Windows Vista also came at that time. And now we are on the completely Windows 10 on the place as of now, right? So every time, whenever Windows upgrade something, upgrade and update something, they're releasing it in the new versions. The same story happened with ServiceNow. You will be surprised to know that ServiceNow releases approximately 18 versions till the date they start beginning in the market. Why this is important to understand? Because in the interview, this question asked many times, on which version of ServiceNow you are working at point of time? Which version is coming in the ServiceNow latest? I will tell you that how you can check on which version of ServiceNow you're working, but maybe tomorrow, not today. So one thing, okay, go to this particular slide and try to identify some common things. I'll give you the 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Roshan, what do you think that what is the common in all these things? All the mentioned names or all the mentions, anything like this? Try to identify some common things here.
Their name started from a city's name.
Okay, that's nice. Their name is starting from the city's name. Okay, fine. Johnson, what you analyze from this slide? What else is common in this particular slides?
I saw two names from Canada.
Okay.
Calgary and Quebec.
Okay. What else? What else?
The colors. The first row is blue, second row is green. I don't know. Okay.
Farha or Shim, what do you find a common?
Are we connected?
Sorry? Okay, no problem. Farha, what you find the common in this slide?
Common in this slide. I'm not sure really.
Okay. Yeah. Iqbi, what do you think? What is the common here?
Atul?
Yes, yes, Sachin. Hello?
I don't
Atul?
Yes, yes, Sachin, tell me.
I don't see any slide.
Huh?
I don't see any slide.
It is there only. Everybody is able to see or some issue? Or let me.
Yes, yes, we can see. You can see.
We can see.
Okay, I need to hang up and come back in again.
Okay, please, sure. Okay, in the meantime, Shim, what do you think?
It start issues, but since 2018, it became two version per in years.
Exactly. Huh? Right. Right. That is the thing which is be required to understand here.
Are we connected?
Yes, 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 Sachin, we are here only. Let me stop sharing and we'll share it again. No problem. Now everyone is able to see my screen?
Yes.
Yes.
Sachin, could you please confirm Roshan and Sachin?
Yes, connected.
Sachin, is it fine now? Iqbi, are you able to see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So now let's come to this point basically, where we identify some common points. That is good. Like Roshan said, every name is a city name here. Aspen, Berlin, Calgary, Dublin, Eureka, Fuji, that's fine. Johnson says that few of the name from the Canada, that is again right. And he says that there's something common in the colors as well, that is again fine. And Shim says that another common point is that every release means after 2014, if you see, ServiceNow releasing two upgrades every year almost, except 2016. 15.2, 16.1, 17.2, 18.2, 19.2, 22, 21. One has been released and one is coming. Okay. Now I tell you, this is the beauty of ServiceNow. Being a functional consultant, being a business analyst, this is a common question asked by the customer to you guys. How you upgrade? When you upgrade ServiceNow, so you can tell to them that ServiceNow has its policy that every year they're releasing the two new versions in the market. One version they release near about April or say March, and another version they're releasing in month of September or October. And every version has a name on the name of any country. Like Cubic is just released now in the March month only. And now they're coming with the Room. that is tentative plan on the month of the September. Okay. So by this is the point which need to be understand, because people ask you, if I am taking interview, I generally ask this question to my interviewee. Tell me which version of ServiceNow you are using. He said, I'm using in the Paris. Okay. What version is going in the market? He said, it's Cubic. What version is coming in the market? It can be a room. Okay. Because if you see from here to here, the ServiceNow has been completely changed. The way of working has been changed. The way of interface has been changed. The way of products, the way of functionality, the way of module has been changed. They enhance a lot of things in the current scenario. We will try to do all this R&D in our sessions now, but our training specifically will be based on the Cubic version. Sachin, I'm putting you on the mute, buddy. There's a lot of noise, background noise. Okay. Ikwi, any question you have?
No, I don't have any questions.
Okay. Now let me go to the exact place which is good for everyone. Okay. But I'll do, let me open this into the image. It will be tough.
Atul, can you mute me? My system got some problem.
I already muted you, buddy. I am muting you again. Okay. My system also have a lot of problem nowadays. Okay. Now we are going to be discussed about the ServiceNow capabilities. Now, if you say that, I take example that what a phone can do for us, to making call, to receiving SMS, to check my emails, YouTube, Gmail, Facebook, anything you can do on your mobile phone, right? The same way ServiceNow categorize the capability in the different sections. Okay. Okay. So on the top, if you see here, that how you can interact with ServiceNow, how you can interact, how you can run, how you can use your mobile phone. At least or minimum, you need a screen where you can see that what happening on my mobile phone, right? That is the one place. So what this is, that you can do the conversation. You can chat with the ServiceNow agent, is the first one. You can use ServiceNow on as a mobile app as well on the top. You can use ServiceNow portal. What is the ServiceNow portal? We will discuss in the different class. But as of now, just understand, service portal means a front end for my users. Like if you want to order something from any of the e-commerce shopping sites, what you need?
Hello.
Yes.
Excuse me, it's Farah. Could you repeat what you just said, please? Because I had for a few seconds, I was disconnected.
Okay, no problem. So we are discussing here that what are the ServiceNow platform interface? It means what are the front ends available for the users to use the ServiceNow? So number one, we have a conversational. Like we can chat with the ServiceNow users either through the WhatsApp, through the Teams, through my Gmail, through my other sources. Okay. Second says that you can install the ServiceNow app in your mobile phone. So this is another way that you can use Gmail. You can use the web-based Gmail, you can use in the app as well. Facebook, you can use as a web-based, you can use as a mobile app as well. Mm-hmm. Okay. Third point is basically called the service portal. And here I put a question that if you want to order something, you want to order some grocery for your home, what is the primary thing you need to order? You need a website. you need a mobile phone mobile app minimum, so that you can open that app or you can open that link and you can place the order. In ServiceNow language, we call this as a service portal, a big topic which we discuss in the later on. Workspace is kind of the place where I can work on my issues, I can work on my tickets, I can work on my assigned problems, my assigned records. That is called the workplace. Like when we go office, we have a dedicated place to sit. We called as a cubicle, we called as a bay, we called as a desk. It means a limited area assigned to you only, so that you can do your lunch, you can do your breakfast, you can do your work, you can put your copies, you can put your diaries, you can put your calendars, you can put your anything on that particular workspace, particular workplace. So that is the same thing happening here, but here that we are giving our user a place we call as a workspace where they can go and check their assigned tickets and can work on the same part. And the last, we have two options. You can integrate, you can connect ServiceNow with third party tool using the APIs, web service API. And finally, we can use the notification. We will discuss this topic in detail, that how the notification works specifically. At point of time, need to be understand, notification is a purpose to communicate with user over the email. Take example, I place some order from Amazon. As soon as I click on the buy now, I put the payment, I got an SMS and I got an email. Your order has been placed. What is that? That is a notification coming to you. Your order has been dispatched, you get an SMS. Your order is out of delivery, you get an email or the SMS. What all these things? These are nothing but these are the notifications only. Okay, understand till this point? Any doubt, any question? Everyone's?
Yes, it's okay.
Roshan, Johnson?
Yes, understand.
Okay. Perfectly. Now I'll tell you one more thing here, that ServiceNow bifurcate his capabilities in a 3 to 4 major areas. Like we bifurcate capabilities of a mobile phone. We say one is a basic, one is advanced, one is a utility. So in the same manner, ServiceNow say one is called the IT workflow, which is only and only used for the IT purpose. Okay. Then they say, second is they say basically employee workflow. If I say employee, definitely you get an idea. Atul, it means the person, the people who are working in a office as the employee. Yes. To maintain them, they're having the employee workflow. And the last, they have the customer workflow. Now, if I take example, you buy a new iPhone, okay, and it stop working, or you need some input on that I need to install some new apps, or you are facing some issue in mobile phone. What do you guys do? You go to the authorized iPhone center and you tell to the person that I'm facing this issue, can you please help me on that part? That person will support you. And this particular discussion, this particular thing is called the customer workflow, because you are neither employee of the iPhone, neither your own company where you're working is giving you the iPhone. You purchase the iPhone from the market, you go to the authorized center and say, boss, my mobile phone is not working, give me some solution on that part. And finally, it's saying the creator workflow. It means if you want to build something you want to build something as per your new need, as per requirement, you want to build a new application. I have a microwave oven at my home, but I want to build a chicken cake. Nobody built till now. I check on the WhatsApp. I check on the YouTube. Nobody built up. Let me build, because I know that how to build or how to make, or how to bake that particular thing. So that is called the creator workflow. It means when you want to build any new app, as per your requirement, you use the creator workflow. Okay. Our in this particular ServiceNow training, now I will tell you that what importantly we are going to be discussing in next 40 to 45 days. Okay. I will give you the overview of this customer workflow. We call this as a CSM, customer service management. This will be the approximately on the 43rd or 44th day we will discuss this CSM. So we'll not pick up this now. HRSG, I'll try to pick up something if possible. Okay. But our main area will be working on the ITSM. Let me do a little more enhancements here. Okay. So number one, now in ITSM also, I have multiple things, multiple flavors, multiple products in ITSM, in IT workflow we have. Number one is called the IT service management. It means these are the modules which are minimum required to run a an operation of any company. It means in ITSM, I have an incident, I have a change, I have a problem, I have a request, I have a knowledge articles, which are minimum required to run any of the operation in day-to-day routine life. Okay. Generally, everybody is familiar about this. ITSM basically service management from the operation perspective. If you remember that in ITL V3, we have a lifecycle service operation. In the service operation, almost everything has been used except change management because it's come in the transition. Okay. So we will discuss all these four modules one by one in detail as well. Okay. Second point come on the ITOM part. Okay. Basically, what do you mean by the word ITOM? ITOM says that IT operation management. Now let's take example. Generally, I take this example. Let me open the. Okay. Now let's have a question. Anyone is married here? Anyone who is married? Okay, nobody is speaking. I guess I put a wrong question here. Let me put example here. Okay, no problem. Let's put example here that Ikwi has his birthday last week. Okay. I'm talking about the time when we are in the school days. Okay. Ikwi celebrated her birthday. Her friends put presents to her. He called 20 friends. And everybody bring a new present for her, new gift for her. What she done? She write all the names of the friend's name and the gift they bring for her in a piece of the paper. Okay, that's fine. That is a habit we have to know, to understand that what he give it to me, because tomorrow when his birthday will come or her birthday will come, I need to be return the same thing to him. Okay. Next year again, Ikwi celebrated her birthday and she again get a lot of gifts now. Now it is tough for her to remember that who gifted what on her birthday. Okay. She again start writing everything on the paper. That's fine. Now she is 18 plus. She put a party in the big bar. She called to all the friends, 30, 40 friends she called. Okay. Everybody came for a party. Everybody bring a present for Ikwi. She take that presents. Now she go to home and put the presents as it is in the wardrobe. Because she is not in the habit now to make and note down everything that what she presented to her on her birthday. Okay. Now, if you think this practice is very time consuming. Why? Because when Ikwi was a little older, she is able to maintain the things on the paper because she just called the 10 or 15 friends on her birthday. But now Equid turned 18. She called a lot of friends. She's in college now. She called a lot of friends. And people bring a lot of gifts for her. And now it is tough for her to maintain the records here. She needs something. She needs someone who can go and tell Equi, your friend, this give to this gift, this particular person give to you this gift. It means she needs either a person on the place, either a machine on the place, either a system on the place, either she needs a barcode on the place so that she can just scan the barcode and understand, okay, this gift given by Farha, this gift given by Johnson, this gift given by Shehim, this gift given by Roshan, this gift given by Sachin, or this gift, or nothing is given by Atul. Okay. It means, if you understand the story as of now, and now I come to this item part. Item is something similar here. When you start your business, when you start your IT company, you have a less resources to maintain. You know that in my company, only 5 people are working. I have 5 laptops. Easy to remember, easy to maintain. Next year, your company has grown to 10 people. You're still able to remember. I have 10 people, 10 name I remember, 10 laptops I issue. That's fine. Now think for a company. Every day in that company, every day, 1,000 new employees are joining. Is it easy to remember the 1,000's name? I'm sure no.
No.
Right? Is it easy to remember that what laptop I have given to everyone? Maybe which brand, which company? Again, tough. No. Right? Then what we need on the place so that I should know that, okay, these many employees are working in my company and these many laptops or these many assets have been issued to them. Because my people are joining from the home as well. My people are joining from the different locations. Then the picture comes the item here. Okay. Item says basically there's a concept called in service now. I'm sure that many of you remember or you know this thing. There's a concept called in service now called the configuration item. If I say we call this as a CI, configuration item. We will discuss this in detail. Okay. So to discover the configuration item automatically, the item come into the picture. We just run a job. We just execute a job. Okay. Which go to my employee network and identify which laptop, which version of laptop is assigned to my employee. What application installed on his or her laptop, right? So in short, if I say that item says that I have majorly 2 or 3 points. Number one is called the discovery, which says go to the client network, go to my customer network and try to identify how many servers they are installed. What type of server they install? It's a Linux server, it's a Windows server. What application running on those server? What RAM, what memory those server has on as of now? It is tough for a single person to go and check every server one by one. So to ease that part, ServiceNow introduced a new flavor called the ITOM, IT Operation Management, and the core concept of item is called the discovery, where we run a job, where we run a kind of a module which go to my client infrastructure and identify that how many server, what type of server, what is memory, what is a RAM installed on that server, and update the things in my CMDB. That is the only thing which is required to understand at point of time. I'm sure it's confusing, but I would like to ask if anyone has any question, any doubt on this part.
Yes, Atul, you just said that it's a little bit confusing between IT operation management and IT asset management. I know that the two things are related to each other, but I think that the IT operations can serve the IT asset management, right? Or totally different, or can be.
So IT operation management is the first step to fulfill the requirements of the ITAM. Unless you don't have the CI on the place, you don't have an asset on the place as well. It means you say that, Atul, I want to buy a laptop, right? Unless you will not buy the laptop, you will not be the owner of a laptop, right? You have no ownership of the laptop, right?
Mm-hmm.
The same thing happens here. So what ITOM do, ITOM go to the customer network, identify the CIs, and then that CIs become the assets for me. Again, it depends from the case to case. When we discuss the CMDB part specifically, then I will show you that how this ITAM actually works. It can be software, it can be hardware. I tell you one very, very basic example here. Okay, let's take example. You installed Facebook. Okay, everyone, it is example for everyone now. You installed Facebook on your mobile phone. Okay, as soon as you install, you log in into the Facebook. Okay, it start giving the recommendation that add Shahim, add Iqbi, add Johnson, add Roshan, add Sachin, add Atul, add Mr. X, add Mr. Y. How these are giving the recommendation to you? Because as soon as you log into the Facebook and you allow the Facebook to access your contacts, it go and access the contacts from there, it bring the name from there, it bring the email ID from there, go to the Facebook websites, sorry, Facebook database, and see, okay, suppose Farha installed the Facebook now. Farha has a contact of Iqbi as well. It will pick up that name, it will pick up that email ID, go to a Facebook database and identify Iqbi, yes, this is the Iqbi and this is the email ID. It matches that and bring on the Farha main screen. Please add Iqbi as your friend. A example of the ITOM. Did the Facebook ask you that please allow me to go into the Iqbi or the database? No. Facebook just asked you, give me permission to access your contacts. And as soon as you give the access to the contacts, it done the ITOM part for you. It start discovering your contacts on the Facebook and start recommending to you. Okay, so that is the example of the ITOM here.
Do you mind my asking? Because I'm also confused. Like Farah, it's hard. Even looking at that table, it's hard to differentiate. Is it you mean like operations management? And please correct me if I'm wrong. Does it refer to like the infrastructure management, or and then asset management deals with like specific applications? Or, like I'm trying to understand it on a high level and also on a technical level.
So I can say yes. Up to some extent, you are actually right. That ITOM is basically from the infrastructure part. Okay, let me take another example here. Okay, we five guys or we six guys started a company now. Okay, we started a business or IT company now, and everybody, we all five got a laptop from our company. Okay. I asked Farha, do you know that Atul has a laptop or not? Farha say yes, because we are only six people in the company. Everybody know that everybody has a laptop, got a laptop from the company. Okay. Tomorrow, if my company grow and from six, our strength reaches to 25 or 30. Is it possible for you to remember all 25 laptops? Definitely no. Right. Right. The solution is that the solution is that you call to all 25 people and start taking their information. Okay, tell me your laptop number, tell me your asset number, tell me your laptop windows, which window you have installed, tell me the RAM, tell me the ROM. You are asking them and you're putting in the Excel sheet so that you can maintain the records. It is still doable part, because 25 is a limited resources. you can call 25 people and get the detail. All right, if we tell this now, clear?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, now let's move to the one more step on the top. After 1 year, my company employee count become the 5,000. Now tell me, is it possible for Farha or Ikvi or Shihim or Johnson or Santosh, or Roshan or Sachin to call to 5,000 people and get the records? Is it possible for any one of you?
No.
You will have a simple answer. Atul, what Ravi? Data entry people here who need to be called to 5,000 people and get the records. And it is not only one recording. You need to ask 100 of the attributes. Tell me your laptop brand. Tell me your laptop version. Tell me your laptop window, RAM, ROM, which application you install. Do you have admin access or not? So it means for a single person, you have 20 attributes to ask. In this case, it is actually not feasible to do the manual part, right? Then ServiceNow thing, boss, if it is not doable for you, don't worry, I am sitting here for your help. What help ServiceNow can do on this part? ServiceNow says, you just install one application in your network. It means, suppose we have our company. In our company, I install that particular code. Okay, that is simple Java code, a small Java class code only. Okay, now what that Java code will do, it will go to all my employees network and identify the all attributes which you are looking. Like if you ping your friend on the WhatsApp, hi, what answer you are expecting from the other person? Hi or hello, right?
Yes.
Right. The same thing happen in the item as well. Once you install that Java class, it will go to your network. As soon as 5,000 employees of my company open their laptop, that code will run in that laptop and bring the information for you. And then bring that information and put it into the CMDB in the service now. And then your data will, then your CMDB will be 100% update. And that is the only purpose of this item here, specifically on the discovery part and service mapping part. Okay, I'm sure once this has been ready, then you can say that which employee has which license. Let's take example. Microsoft required only one license and you can give it to everyone. You can use Outlook, you can use Word, PowerPoint, anything you can use. But now Microsoft changed the strategy completely. They introduced Office 365. In that 365, they have different flavors, right? A person who is the top management, who is working in the top management in a company, he will get a full license. But if a fresher join a company, he will get only the basic license. He cannot install the Microsoft Outlook because he is not entitled with that particular license. Okay, so to maintain all these things, either hardware or other software, we have a concept called the IT asset management. Okay, any doubt, any question on this point?
No.
Okay, good. Okay, perfectly fine. Now let me go to this one. ITBM, business management. Even though we will discuss this in a completely end-to-end format in our last working days, approximately 44, 45 days, we will discuss these things. But what is the purpose of ITBM is that Atul Grover is a businessman. I'm not bothered that what is going on the operation. I am bothered that how many resources are working in my company, how many billing I am doing for that particular person, what projects I am running at point of time. to maintain all these things, ServiceNow introduced a concept called the ITBM. And this is again a separate module. Separate licenses are required for these things. Okay, done till this point. Only over these things are required. Give me a minute. Okay. So in our ServiceNow training, we will be mainly discussing on this part, a little bit on this, little bit on this, and a little bit on this part. Okay. And rest again, ServiceNow give me a DevOps kind of a way to execute your work, security operations that in case any ransom or malware happen in your network, how to deal those type of incidents is basically on that part, and your risk management specifically on the GRC part, that is called the governance, risk and compliance come into this picture at point of time. Okay. Other than this, ServiceNow has a separate applications for these industries as well, for the financials, for the telecom, and for the telecom network and telecom services as well. Okay, these are the different modules. I'll not say the modules, these are the different application which ServiceNow is working and already worked for the different industries. Now, if you want to maintain your finances, complete end-to-end finances, you can use the financial operations as well. Okay, now I come to this point, which is important for us to be understand. Okay, this is called the Now platform. When I say the Now platform means, see, I am teaching you something, the way of teaching, the way of putting examples is my proprietary, right? Nobody can take it from me. Nobody can get it from me unless I will give them a kind of handover of the knowledge transfer. In the same way, ServiceNow says that, boss, I have something called the Now platform. Means, which is built by me, which is maintained by me, but you can use those platform modules or the platform functionality in your application development. The topmost called the Flow Designer. We will discuss this again in the detail, major incident or issue management. You can use the machine learning, and for that you have the reporting, you have the performance analytics, you have the predictive intelligence. You can think, okay, last year in month of December when we have a Christmas, my sale goes 200% up and my server was not responding properly. Let me work on this thing now, so that because this year I'm expecting the sale should be go by 400%. So to do these things, I have a predictive intelligence on the place. I have a performance analysis on the place. I have a reporting on that place. Then for the user experience, I'm 100% sure you guys are getting confused, but this is the way that we will start one by one. Don't worry, we will pick up as per our agenda, we will pick up a lot of things from here. Okay. User experience. When I say example that you can go, suppose you are working in a company. Okay, your laptop is not working. What do? You take a laptop to the IT department. Simple example, that is called the walk-up experience. Your mobile phone is not working. You go to the authorized service center, right? It means you are doing the walk-up part. Then reusable data model, CMDB is one of the things. Knowledge management. So almost other than CSDM and skills management, we will discuss everything in detail, complete detail. That what is the meaning of the SLM, that is service level management. What is the meaning of that? How you can implement that? Service catalog, how you can use that? How you can implement that? Then my security part. My authentications, it should be SSO enabled. It can be multi-factor authentications, a little bit on that part. And then finally on the admin part, that how I can change something in my form. I want to make changes in my form level. I want to make or add or delete any new field or old field or new field, I want to be do that part. How I can design my service portal? You guys able to see the Amazon website? This is nothing but a service portal. And in ServiceNow, we have functionality which you can do the service portal designer. And finally, that if I want to upgrade my ServiceNow instance, how I can do that part? Okay. Your homework for today is that you need to be go through these terms. Just go and read those terms so that you can understand, okay, these things are coming in future for me to be understand. Okay, let me stop here for a minute. Any doubt, any question, any clarification required till this point?
No, it's clear.
And don't be confused. We will be taking a lot of things in the coming days. Separate topic, we will pick it up and we'll do in the detailed manner. Okay.
It's okay.
Mm-hmm. Johnson, Roshan, any doubt, any question?
It's clear.
Johnson, all clear? Or you still feeling sleepy now?
I mean, it's clear, but since you say you're going to be going over each of them one by one, mm-hmm. In the next couple of days, I think I'll just have patience for now because I was a little bit kind of confused. Okay. Because all these are new terms to most of us on this call. But I think the moment you start going through them one by one, I think you make more sense.
Right. So see, let me put one more thing clear, that we are not going to discuss every topic one by one. But yes, as per the topics which we discussed already as a part of the training, I'll pick up one by one things and will tell you that how you can utilize. So as of now, again, your only homework is that you need to be go through this particular capability page. I'll put this image in the chat window. Okay. And try to search something about these things. That what is this? How I can do this thing? How I can use these things? Read about ServiceNow basics today. So that tomorrow when we'll kick off our next topics, you guys on the same place with the same speed with me, so that you can understand the things in the right manner. Okay. Now let me go to the slides. Okay. In ServiceNow, we have total, or I can say, three type of users mainly. Okay. Mainly, I'm saying on the top level. I'm not going on the bottom level because multiple type of user exist. Okay. Now take example. Roshan want to order something from the Amazon website. What is the minimum requirement for Roshan to something order from the Amazon? Roshan, what minimum you need to order something from Amazon? Tell me what
minimum account.
Exactly. He need an account. Okay. Now the second point is that if he need an account, do he need to pay for the same to create the account?
No.
Right. It means for Amazon, Roshan is a end user who is using just that portal to get something done, to order something. Until unless you want to become a Prime member, that is a separate thing. But people who are using Amazon maximum are a non-Prime member. They're not paying anything to them. They're not getting any licenses for them. So in the same way, when I talk about ServiceNow, the person who is using my service portal, on that portal, who can order something, who can access my knowledge article, who can raise incident on my portal is called the end user. And now I request everyone, let's start thinking from the ServiceNow perspective. I'm taking the normal layman example, but definitely I will take the ServiceNow example as well. Take example, Ikwi, Johnson, Farah, and Sheem. they're supporting a customer who raised the incident from the portal, and these four guys are working on that incident. That person is the end user for them. He just raised the incident, boss, my laptop is not working, that's all. Now these four will work on that incident. Okay. The person who is raising that incident is called the end user. Okay. Now the question comes, the person or the team or the group of the people who are working on that incident, those are called the fulfiller. So Iqbi, Farah, Sheen and Johnson are the fulfiller. They all are having the expertise, they all are having the specialized skill in that, and they want to resolve the incident for that customer. Why you call to automobile mechanic to fix the issue of car or bike? Why you not call the plumber for the same? An example, any guesses on that? Simple reason, he don't have a skill, right? He's not specialized in that area. Or no? Everybody is speaking on mute, I guess.
Can you repeat the question,
please? Okay. My question is that, why you guys call automobile engineer to fix some issue in your mobile or bike, sorry, in your car or bike, not to a plumber to fix that issue? Because plumber don't have that specialized skills on that part, exactly. Right? Yeah. In the same manner, when we work in the IT industry and the pop and the user and the people who are working on any incident to fix that issue is called the fulfiller. And fulfiller people need the license called the ITIL. Okay, so remember this thing. If someone asks you in your discussion, in your interview, or any customer asks you that if my team, my operation team, want to resolve any incident, do they need the license? Yes, they required a license, and that license name is called the ITIL. License. Okay. Clear till
point. ITIL, yes. License for user who are requesting.
No. Sorry? No. ITIL license are required for those users who are fixing that incident or the change or the problem. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Those require license because they need to be logging into the service now and to work on that particular ticket. Right. Simple funda is that if you want to use the internet on your mobile phone, you have to pay for the same, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if I have a very old phone, that keyboard phone I have, and no internet facility available on that part, it means I can make the call easily without paying any license fees on the same. Okay. So remember this point. Now going forward, for me, you guys are the fulfiller here, because you guys are going to be work on incident, change, problem and request and knowledge as well. Okay. Understand any doubt, any question till this point? Everyone, please confirm quickly.
No, it's okay.
Yes, understand.
Okay, perfectly fine. Okay, and the last one which I put it here is basically, now take example. Okay, and now I take example from the Johnson. Okay, Johnson is the age of 14 and 15 as of now. He want to buy a motorbike. He know that motorbike is too much costly. He don't have that much money in his pocket now. What Johnson will do now? He will reach out to his father and ask his father that I need more money to buy the bike. That's fine. Johnson's father asked a question to Johnson. Why you need the bike? Number one, Johnson need to be justified that point. Second, what you will do if you get the bike? Johnson justify. Okay. Number three, in case your bike is not good, I will not responsible for the same. Third point, Johnson justify, agree on that part. And finally, Johnson's father agreed to give the amount to Johnson to get a bike. Now, if you see this complete scenario, what is the purpose that Johnson go to his father to get a bike? Mainly two reasons. Number one, he don't have that much budget that he can go to market and buy the bike himself. That is the first reason. Second reason, because he is not 18 plus now, he is not be counting in the adult category now, he need approval from his father. Because if something goes wrong tomorrow with bike, his father should know, yes, he also agreed to get a bike for Johnson. In service now, the same thing happened. When we discuss about the request management, then we will see this in detail. In service now, we have a user called the approver. In this case, Johnson father is the approver and he has authority to approve that. And he approved this thing. It means in service now, if I am an approver, simple example, Ikwi, Farah, Sheen, Johnson, everybody is working in the IT industry. If you guys need a leave, annual leave, for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, you send an email to your managers or the reporting manager. I'm going on leave from this particular date to this particular date. Please approve it. You are taking the approval. In service now, we are taking the approval in the tool, and for that, a person required the license on the place. Okay, that is called the approver license. Understood till this point? Any doubt, any question?
No, it's clear.
Yeah, understood.
It's a nice example, right? Johnson, what do you say?
What do I say?
What do you say that it is a nice example or not?
It is a nice example, sorry.
Okay, fine. So with this, we are done with the ServiceNow introduction as of now. Okay. We will connect again tomorrow. And tomorrow I will take you on the tour of the ServiceNow. Tomorrow you will see that how ServiceNow look like. I will guide you that how you can take your own instance to do the practice part. Okay, so let me stop the recording here. And then before I close the recording, any doubt, any question, any clarification?
No, thank you, Atul.
No, thank you, sir.
Let me stop the recording here.